Hello my dear friends, welcome back to Sparkle with Jyoti. So excited for today's video because this video is going to be all about resume building, what kind of resume you should have, especially if you are looking for jobs in Sweden. So before getting started, please go down and hit the subscribe button and also the bell button so that you are notified of my each and every video. And also those who are new, my name is Jyoti. I make all the videos about Swedish lifestyle, culture, how to settle down here and what are the obstacles and the solutions for settling here in Sweden. So yeah, so I'm waiting. It's absolutely free, doesn't cost you anything. Please go and subscribe. All done, awesome. So let's get started, right, guys. And before getting started, I want to update you that I am going to share my own resume, okay, my own resume for reference. Of course, not with all the details, but the overall format and the template, you know, how it should look like, what points you should include and everything. And this is going to be at the end of the video. So do stick for the till the end of the video and we will go into my resume in detail, in depth of each and every point and how what you should include and how your resume should look like. Okay, so yeah, so let's get started now. So guys, the first question what you should ask yourself, or we generally do ask ourselves, is that you know, how different a Swedish CV looks like? Is it different from the other countries, like especially where I have come from, India? So is it different? So to answer that question, that no, it's actually not that different. It's quite similar, and keeping up with the latest trends and the latest job market, you know, almost if you apply these rules and apply this knowledge to all the countries, it's fine. But there are also some very specific Swedish Swedish rules, or you can say, you know, if you oblige that and if you follow that, then there are more chances of you landing a job in Sweden. So those points we will discuss in detail later on, but let's go first into the normal generic format or the points which you can apply while making your resume. So guys, how you should approach your CV, or what kind of format you should follow. So just think of it that you are trying to sell something to other person, and you have to be as lucrative and as interesting as possible so that the other person buys you, right? So in this case, you're literally selling yourself or your competencies, your skills, your personality, everything about you, and the other person doesn't know you at all, right? And the more interesting you make, the more like mirch masala, what you say, you add up, that's going to interest the employer or the recruiter or whoever is reading your resume. And that will try to bring like that smile to the face, you know, try to have something different included in the letter. And don't try to have like a very straightforward, dry kind of a document which just has some letters, like a Word document, and you just read. And you know, this HR people, they are reading thousands of resumes every day, okay? And it's quite boring for them to go through like each and every resume, and it says the same thing, like education, experience and all that. So if you try to include like a fun element or interesting element about you or something unique, you know, that will spike the interest of the recruiter, and he will stand up, pay attention, and oh, let me read this, you know, what is it that it is so interesting. So definitely I will suggest try to have some kind of interesting elements in a resume rather than having just a plain document. And also it's very important to have like whatever achievements you have done in your previous companies. That might not look that huge that time when you did it, or also for the employer in that particular company, but that matters, right? So maybe you can have like a one-liner or something on whatever you have done or achieved. That can be any small activity or any initiative you have taken, a voluntary initiative or some fun thing, or organizing something, you know, that gives a different kind of a good element to your resume. So you can include that definitely. So the next question what you often get in our minds is that whether you should have your CV in Swedish or in English. That's a very common argument what your mind has, you know, and especially when you're applying jobs from India or from your home countries to Sweden, you don't know what works and what doesn't, right? So what I suggest is that when you read the ad or the job description or the job ad, you can see the language what they are using in order to, you know, publish their ad. So if suppose the job ad is in English, you can easily go ahead and write your resume in English. But suppose it is in Swedish, then it becomes a little tricky. obviously it is recommended that you should have your resume in the same language what the ad has. So if it is in Swedish, you should write in Swedish. But again, another point comes in this, that whether you know to speak Swedish, right? Because if you write your resume in Swedish, the employer, the recruiter feels that, okay, fine, that this person is speaking Swedish. That's the reason she has written, he or she has written the resume in Swedish. But if you do not know to speak in Swedish, or if you do not understand Swedish at all, then please mention that, or do not write your resume in Swedish. In that case, when the ad is in Swedish, try to go for English only. And if also also mention that if you're taking any special courses in Swedish, like if you're trying to learn Swedish, if you're trying to take courses to learn Swedish, then please mention that, make it a part of your resume and mention that below, that you are learning Swedish currently and you are in so or so level. Like for example, you can speak, but you can speak a little bit basic Swedish, or you can understand but cannot speak. So whatever it is, just mention it, okay? And in that case, go ahead and make your resume in English itself. And also another thing is that you can even call the recruiter, you know. That is another important or a good thing about a Swedish ad, that when they put up ad, they may also mention at the below the contact number of the recruiter or the person or the hiring manager. So you can easily call them and ask them, you know, that yes, I have so and so doubt. So, you know, will you be able to guide me in this case? They are very open. But in case they don't answer your phone, okay, because they do not answer random phones. If the number is not saved in their phone list, they usually try to ignore and not answer. So I recommend you shoot them a mail, you know, send them an email instead of a call. Try calling them. If they don't pick up, try sending an email or email them, and if you don't get a reply, then you can call them or even text them, okay? So that is a very good way of connecting. And also do mention that, why are you calling? Like, I am so and so. You just don't write, you know, oh, I have a question, this is a question. Please first introduce yourself and then ask the question, so that they know, okay, in reference, like on what context you're asking. There is also an ad number or an ad, you know, a detail there. So you can also mention, in reference to this particular ad, I am asking you this question, and I am sure they will be happy to answer your query, okay? So many times we also have a question, you know, that is, there's also an argument whether you should include your picture or no, okay? So there are various theories and various studies on that, you know, whether you should or should not include your picture. But I highly recommend that you should and you must include a nice photograph in your CV, okay? That's very important, because when you put your picture, you know, on the resume, it shows so many things. It shows your eyes, your expressions, your face, and at least it sends a little vibe to the other person who is watching. And also, it's very good to put a face to the name, right? So it makes it very good for the other person to imagine, okay, fine, this person looks like that, and you know, has a particular style. So for example, I am wearing this kind of very professional you know, this in India, it might be not that professional, this outfit, but in Sweden, it is definitely, because, you know, there is cold. So you can wear like pink or blue without any designs, and you can have and can pose and you can give a nice photo, take a nice photograph, and you can include that in a resume that shows that you're professional, as well as it shows your face to the employer. And it's very good. So I highly recommend doing that. So let's summarize or rewind whatever we have seen till now. So make your resume interesting. Do not make it boring. Try to use good, interesting elements so that the other person is quite intrigued to see your resume and, you know, spikes his interest. And also make it very easy to read, you know. Do not use like very abstract words, or, you know, don't go haywire. Keep it in proper good structure, and make it very easy and interesting to read, okay? Now let's go into the Swedish specific points, what you should follow if you are looking for a job in Sweden, okay? So let's go into that points now. So the first question what we have, or maximum people do ask me, is that whether you should translate your documents or your educational documents or work documents into Swedish, okay? So if you can, if you have access to that kind of tool, you can definitely translate. But usually English is quite understood here by all the companies and by all the employers, and they do understand what kind of qualifications it refer to, like if you are masters, they do know like what it entails and what it has, okay? And also if you have some technical qualifications, like if you know some languages, or if you know some tools, then please do mention that. And also from which universities you have done, or for example, if you have done from Coursera or it's a Udemy course, you know, you can mention that, as well as you can mention the time and the frame when you have done that course. So to answer the question that it is not necessary or it is not mandatory at all, if you can, you can keep two sets, like, you know, one your resume and cover letter in Swedish and one in English. You can do that, but it's not mandatory at all. Now, another important thing what I want to mention is that though you have listed your technical qualifications and your education qualifications and your work experience as well, but still, you know, in Sweden culture, they do look for the human skills, like what kind of personality or qualities you bring on the table. So that is more important for them. Okay, so for example, they want you to be like a team player and to be a part of the entire Swedish culture. So, you know, that is huge topic on which I would like to make a video later on, but today we are speaking about CV, so I will try to stick to only CV and resume. And so my advice is, you try to bring that personal element into your resume as well, like what kind of as I mentioned before, what kind of side hustles you do, what kind of you know, personality you have, or what kind of extracurricular activities you have been part of in your college duration, your masters, or you know, in your entire career. That will also make very good sense. Also, it's very important to mention what kind of languages you speak, you know, in all formats, like in written, spoken, you know, they want to know like what kind of languages you know, because since even though it is Sweden in Europe, but then it's like a global thing. So it's always good for them to know what kind of languages you do speak, and they usually are aware of what languages are there. Okay, so it's very good to mention that. And also, you know, the computer literacy is extremely high in Sweden. So, you know, you just cannot mention that yes, you can serve to the internet and you do know MS Office. So try to be specific about that, like in MS Office, what, you know, specific, like can you do PowerPoint presentations, or do you have any tools you know of, like you know, or if you know any languages like Java or C++, or do you know, for example, Canva designing, or do you know like blog writing or content writing. You know, try to go into specific into your skills and try to mention that. So, you know, that is more that will be more good for you, and the employer will get a clear idea. They like to be specific, they like to have specific details about some things. So try to mention that, and do not just mention that yes, I know MS Office, or I know to use internet. That will not be enough. You have to go much deeper and give the specific details in your resume. Another important thing is a driver's license. Okay, driver's license is extremely important in Sweden, because you know, as you know, that although the public transport is extremely good and there is no need of that, but then if you are applying to a car company, for example, you are applying to Volvo, you know, then obviously they will that will be like a added element, you can say a plus point, you know, you will get if you try to if you do have driver's license. So try to include that if you do have driver's license, please mention that. Now guys, let's go into my laptop or into the presentation of the resume and how does it look like, and I will talk about each and every point. So let's go. So guys, let's dive into the resume now. Okay, so as you can see here, I have mentioned my name, okay, and the title whatever you have. So if it is regional manager or you know, operations manager or whatever, just write your title here. And then you have to write your professional summary here, which is very important. Okay, and professional summary does not mean that what you have been doing in the past, but that means what are your goals for the future. Okay, extremely important. Write with good words. Okay, and good and concise and very clear words. And then you can mention your experience, so and so company, your title for that particular company, your roles and responsibilities for that company, the duration what you have been working for that. And then this side you have your photograph, so include a nice smiling photograph here. In contact, you can mention your mobile number, your contact number, very important, your email ID here. And then if you have been doing any side hustle, or any, like if you are a freelancer, or if you have any content writing gigs or whatever it is, you can mention here. Okay, so if you have your website or a WordPress site, you can definitely mention in this particular section. also include the area or the location where you are living. And here in this space, you can mention if you are doing something else, like if you are writing, for example, I have my YouTube channel, so I will put a sticker of YouTube channel here and give a link, which will, if the person clicks on that particular link, it will directly take them to the YouTube channel. Okay, so that's interesting. And so you can mention that. Also very important to mention your LinkedIn profile here. So please mention your LinkedIn. Again, same thing, mention the LinkedIn sticker here, and then directly link it to your LinkedIn profile. And please avail a lot of resume templates in Canva, so you can try to use that. I will link that in the description box for you, so you can definitely use that. Mention your education here, just a year and a title like MBA or engineer or, you know, whatever it is, you can mention it here. Again, next is skill set. So whatever skills you have, for example, you can do Canva designing, you can you are a content writer, you are a graphic designer, whatever skills you have, mention in this section with bullet points. Okay. And then again, this is experience, right? Your achievements here, whatever you have achieved in your life. For example, I've written my YouTube channel, and this is also linked. So if anybody clicks here, it will directly take them to my YouTube channel link. Okay. And then you can mention whatever, suppose you have got an award or, you know, any big achievement mentioned in this particular section. Here I have written my home country experience in short. Okay. So just I have written like whatever years I have worked for and what was my experience, whatever companies I have worked for, my roles and responsibilities in short. Okay, no need to write long. Here you can mention your internships, whatever internships you have done in your life. Then it comes certification. So please write, like, for example, digital marketing from West University, Google Analytics from Oxford University, whatever it is, just mention in from which university you have availed this particular course. This side is again interest, so please mention like you like singing, dancing, or you know, blogging, photography, anything you can mention this particular section. So this is the template, just 2 pages, very interesting looking, and visually give them a visual experience, and it looks interesting as well as very easy to read and understand just in very less amount of time. So yeah, this was the template. I hope you liked it. So guys, I hope you have understood everything, and if you have any doubts, you can please you know, ask me. And one more thing is that if you want to avail this particular resume template which I have shared with you, then please comment resume in my comment section, and I'll be happy to share with you like we did you know, last time. So that doesn't make sense you know, to just share randomly, because everybody doesn't need it, right? So if you need it, then please mention in the comment section resume, and I will be happy to share with you through your email ID and all. Okay. And yes guys, that was my video. I'm sorry for the long video, but I wanted to cover each and every point. So I hope you have you know, got good information. And yeah guys, please let me know in the comment section what do you think about the video. And definitely I'm going to make a separate video on the cover letter, as well as the different tips and tricks what you should apply specifically for Swedish market. So do stay tuned for that. And yeah, I will see you in my next video. Till then, stay positive and stay happy. Bye bye, take care.